perfect people. And we need to stop presenting ourselves that way, both on and offline, because it's not real, and because I believe there's value in the real me and in the real you. And because presenting ourselves that way can actually be quite damaging to everyone involved. And I'll explain what I mean here. We're always comparing each other, whether we are cognizant of it or not. It happens on a conscious and a subconscious level, especially in social media platforms. And part of that is normal. But when you're comparing yourself to a perfect version of someone or something, then it's not really a true comparison. That reality is often a, not necessarily a false reality, but it's really hiding behind that facade of perfection. And there's nothing wrong with presenting your best self when you're presenting at all. But if we don't ever allow people to see our rough spots, then it creates this false narrative that we're always polished, right? And that's not, it's not real. It's not a standard that we can actually keep up with. And it lends to self-destructive thoughts and beating ourselves up when we're caught in a moment where something is not so perfect or is exposed. And the problem with that is that people who might benefit from knowing about our struggles and our challenges and how we work through those, how we manage those, how we overcome those. People who we don't share that with, they don't get to benefit from having that connection. And we don't get to benefit from having that connection. You can take, for example, this video podcast. So I edit out the dead space. I edit out the amount of times that I say, and not because I'm hiding behind that, but because I believe that it distracts from, it takes away from the topic. But if someone were to watch me and think, oh, wow, you're so good. How do you do that? How do you just speak so clearly and directly into the camera? I would have to be honest with them and say, well, there are edits. I'm clipping this. There is dead space. I say, way too many times. And so that's what I deal with in the editing process. So there's a vulnerability in not being perfect. But the thing that makes the connections real and beautiful when they happen is that we can learn from each other. We can teach, we can learn, we can grow, we can support, we can encourage, we can show compassion, we can make connections. We are all unique individuals with our own struggles and successes that are worth sharing because it's a part of our story. Because failing means that we're actually doing something in the first place. And because our connections are so much stronger when we can relate to one another, and it's hard to relate to someone who's never been through anything. It's hard to relate to people who have never struggled or had any challenge. And we know that that's not true. We know that everybody struggles, everybody has challenges, but to my original point, if we're only showing what is perfect all the time and like I described is not actually a reality, but if that's all people see and we never allow people to see us have those moments where we are challenged because that's also a part of our story, then we are really selling ourselves short, and it really can and does impact the way that we can connect with other people, the way that we can show empathy and compassion, the way that we can move from having relationships that are more surface level to having more of a depth of a connection.